Mortal Instruments is directed by Christian Rivers and it stars Hera Hilmar, Robert Sheehan, and Hugo Weaving, among others. It's set in a post-apocalyptic world where cities ride on wheels and consume each other to survive, and two people meet in the city of London to try and stop a major conspiracy that can destroy the world that they know. Guys, I walked into this film not expecting anything. I only watch teaser trailers nowadays for movies, and to this one I made an exception since the teaser trailer really was nothing. I watched the second one and I felt like I watched the whole film. I was not prepared for how bad this movie is. Let's start with the good stuff though, the visual effects. The visual effects, for the most part, they look really good. The cities, the landscapes, the ships that they fly on, that's all fine and dandy. And the one robot in this film, they look good. They look really good. The green screen on the backgrounds, however, when you have close-up or mid-shots on characters, those don't look that good. And now let's go to the bad, which is basically everything else. Every character in this film is a cliche ripoff of every other young adult novel that you know. Every story beat is a cliche ripoff of every story that you know. This film steals so much from Star Wars on the last act alone. Not to mention the rest of the film. There are moments in this film where it is so cliche, you know everything that is going to happen in this film. In the last moments of the film, there's this huge reveal, and I'm like, oh my god, I thought the movie was better than this. For some reason, I did, but of course it isn't. Hugo Weaving is bored to tears in this film. He's doing absolutely nothing. I bet he only agreed to be in this film because Peter Jackson is producing it and because he wears an awesome wig on the flashbacks. And there's a lot of flashbacks because that is one of the major issues of this film. This film is nothing. This is a non-story. This is a bunch of people meeting and telling their backstory to each other. There are these two characters, person A and person B, that meet, and person B tells their backstory. Meanwhile, they meet person C, and person A tells their backstory. Meanwhile, they meet person D, and person C tells their backstory, and on and on and on. And it's always like that, to that last moment that I mentioned, that there's this huge reveal that I'm not going to spoil, but you know what it's going to be. From the first 10 minutes, from the first flashback that you see, you know what is going to happen in this film. There is nothing going on in this film besides this major city of London heading out to meet this wall that they want to cross. And that is it. The rest of the film is just these much more interesting, and just note that the bar is very low, so these much more interesting backstories take the bulk of the film. There's this huge robot that's going after the girl, the main girl of the film, and it doesn't really make sense. They don't explain what this robot is, how it exists in this world. They don't explain this world. This world looks so magnificent, so interesting. This robot looks like it could be something interesting to explore, and it really isn't. The first time that you see him, he shows up in a swamp, and his eyes are glowing green, and they call him Shriek, and I thought I heard Shrek when they talked about him, and so I was about to yell out of my lungs, "Get out of my swamp," in the middle of the film, and I didn't, but I cracked up a lot of times. Honestly, I was surprised the lows that this film reached. You don't care about any of the characters. None of them have interesting relationships. They barely have relationships. The film tries to create chemistry and romantic sparks between two couples, and it really doesn't work. No decisions make sense. No characters make sense. The world doesn't make sense because it's not explained. And it's so obvious every step that this film is going to take. Honestly, the only thing I really respect about this film is that it doesn't have a last shot setting up a sequel in the most obvious way possible, even though it does everything else in the most obvious way possible. Earlier this year, I reviewed another film based on a young adult novel called The Darkest Minds, and I thought that film was really cliché, but this beats it to the punch. The film is pretty to look at most of the times, but this story is so irritating, is so annoying, so insulting to anyone's intelligence, anyone who has ever read a book, and everyone who has ever seen a film, because this film rips so much off out of basically everything I can think of. Mortal Engines is one of Hollywood's biggest wastes of money in recent history. I just might hate this film more than Robin Hood, just by a little bit. I'm going to give Mortal Engines a D-. What did you think of Mortal Engines, my beautiful geekies? Did you enjoy it? Did you not? Did you read the book? Because the books might be good. So let me know in the comments below. And thank you so much for watching, guys. Have the best tomorrow. I'm watching Aquaman. And on Saturday, Bumblebee. And I still have many other reviews for you. So stay tuned and stay beautiful and geeky. And if you have to, so you have to click the subscribe button and the bell. So we can be geeky united!